Welcome to the fourth special edition of Behind the Legends. This one is again for evidence and documentation purposes. We take a look at what has happened to us in the last few days. 3 years ago, several young women were brutally murdered. Each of them had an eye removed. One of the victims was Sarah Stiller. The series of murders ended with her until suddenly, 3 years later, you received a mysterious call for help on the dating app Love Radar. The horror began anew. More and more people lost their lives. Mary, Lewis, Jason, even Alicia, and Lily found themselves in mortal danger. Only one of them survived. Danu was the last to die. You and I followed another lead on the sidelines. 7 years ago, our town was already haunted by a murderer, Michael Bates, alias the Mindbender. He had established a cult, or rather a group of followers. Michael's former colleague, Nico, made an important discovery. The Argus killer could have been one of these followers. Shortly afterwards, the killer contacted you. He kidnapped Amy, Sarah's sister. If you don't succeed in destroying Argus, he will kill her. Suddenly, a mysterious guy called Ace contacted you. He gave you some interesting background information about Argus. But the question is, can we trust him? From then on, everything went from bad to worse. Ace forwarded the Cinemombies video of a woman called Vanessa Thomas. 3 years ago, she made an eerie discovery in the catacombs beneath her house. Argus was probably held there for decades or longer until he escaped from his prison 3 years ago. Is that when the Argus murders began? Caro, Ben, and Fontaine drove to Westbrook to take a closer look at the place, but terrors lurked in the catacombs. Argus chased them through the dark corridors. It was up to you to lead them out safely. Now, the prospects are better than ever because Caro, Ben, and Fontaine found a book in the catacombs. It contains clues to a ritual that can be used to destroy Argus.
Believe me, you are not safe either. I will devour your world too.
Hi there. I might lose reception anytime. I'm driving through the forest now.
I am Rebecca Baumann, and this is important breaking news. A few hours ago, we reported a major development in the Argus murders case. Yuna Kempf, the sister of one of the victims, was arrested on suspicion of being involved in these crimes. However, as we've learned from police sources, Yuna Kempf has just been released from custody as the suspicion could not be upheld. We don't have any more information at this stage, but we will, of course, keep you up to date with the latest developments. Stay tuned.
That's right. Juna has been released from prison. Her lawyer has masterfully dismantled the case. From the beginning, everything seemed too smooth. The evidence too arranged, as if it had been placed right in front of her eyes. And now, after Juna's release, Boris is seething with rage. He was so hell-bent on convicting her, but somehow, deep down, I always had my doubts. It was all too seamless, almost as if someone had orchestrated it.
just dropped me off at my house. She's also... What the hell?!
So according to these records, the ritual must be held in a room full of eyes. Well, we're missing some information, because there's a page missing here. But it's clear. We need 4 objects for the ritual. Wait, I'll send you a photo again.
We can discuss where and how the ritual should take place later. For now, we should take care of the things we need for it. Soil of the dead? That could mean soil from a grave, right? In other words, from a cemetery. And what were the other things again? Just wait a minute.